All right, there are a number of ways to do this, a number of theories. My idea is to not have to do too much work. Some people have cut the nose up here and left the windshield frame, and that works. Some people have actually removed the material, ground it out from underneath. That is very difficult, and you could ruin your window frames. Mine are not too bad. There is some Bondo up in here. I remember doing it 20 years ago, so there are some rust through holes. So I figure I'll take this opportunity to cut this out, the window frame. I think it would be easier for me to grind and repair a weld here and here, just three spots, as opposed to a long weld anywhere else. So I'm going to go ahead and replace the lower sill. Haven't decided yet where to make the cut. Probably not up here in the straight section. Probably down here where it curves. I have an idea, but I think that it's really important to get this joint exactly right. And I think the easiest way for me to do that is to weld it on right now before I do anything else. That way, no matter what, I can get this right. Get this line straight. I mean, this is what everyone's going to look at first. They're going to look at this straight line, the welds here. I think everything else can be fudged or adjusted, but this first has to look its best. So my theory is to do like VW did, which is to weld the windshield frame on first. Just those two pieces. We'll see if that actually works. In this photo, you can see the windshield frame and the nose skin fitted together in a jig about to be welded. One of my pet peeves looking at buses in shows is when I see this overlap seam filled in, or bondoed, or seam sealed. It doesn't look right. To me, it should have that overlap, and it should just have a very light coat of paint in there so that you can see that those are two pieces, separate pieces of sheet metal. Now, VW spot welded these two pieces together without any primer in there, because that doesn't work. So that's one of the reasons why they tend to rust out. So I have an opportunity to do it a little bit better than that. My plan is to get some primer up under there just a little, and some primer in here underneath, up just part way. You know, I'll sand this and make it smooth so that it doesn't have a sharp edge, so that it'll hold the primer, epoxy primer. But I'll still leave this part bare so that I can weld that. I also have an opportunity, if I choose, to drill my plug weld holes in the nose and plug weld it from behind. I haven't decided yet. One thing I can do while I'm deciding is to cut out the bullets and install those. I used a laser to level the truck, and I made marks here on the bullet faces so that I can get the alignment properly. bite the bullet.
So I found 5 spot welds. They're pretty easy to see. And marked them and then transferred the marks to the other side. And I used a cutoff wheel on edge to grind the metal really thin so that I can break the spot welds. Because I need the nose skin, this oval, as a template to transfer that oval shape, which is not symmetrical. There's a top and a bottom, to the new nose skin. So I'm going to break the rest of the metal off. Grinding, just about loose. This one's still hanging on. All right. Now I have a good template to trace. It's kind of egg-shaped. Look at that. Even though VW dipped these things, none of the primer actually got in there. The black dip stops right here. A 68. By 51. That's where it goes.